to you guys, what do you think the big appeal of the show is?
It has so much heart. Yeah. I mean, that's one of the things that I love about it. You know, it's like not only is it beautiful animation, delightful casting and characters, but I mean, it's a really touching show, I find.
Yeah.
Which I love anime with no substance that are just pretty pictures and great action sequences as well. But to have like a really great story and compelling characters, I mean, I think it hits every single nail on the head and hits it really well.
I wasn't sure about it at first. I've watched a lot of anime, and I'm like, all right, this is coming to Funimation, what is this? And I watched the first episode, and I'm like, okay, heroes, got it. A lot of hero stuff happening, right? MCU is like 10-year-long run. I mean, Game of Thrones just finished. A lot of, they're not heroes, but you know what I mean. Long
no
running.
Spoilers.
No spoilers. Everyone dies. Yeah, after watching the second episode, I'm very into symbolism and kind of character analysis as well, and watching in classic anime style, right? The school of misfits, and everyone's got different abilities. I love the idea of superpowers, and the idea, at least the way I view it, like as a metaphor for what makes people special. Their quirk, calling it a quirk, is a really specific word. Yeah. And I love that because some people have really awesome quirks, and some people have not so awesome quirks. And yet, it's you know, emblematic or very, very close to how, I think, personally, how people are in life. And we travel through our lives, and some of us are good at some things, and others aren't so good, but we can all work on what makes us special. Yeah. Not that that's too kind of, like, soft-hearted, but really, like, I love the show because there are people that can just straight up, like, I can fill this coffee cup with my quirk, and that's what they do. And it's humble, and it's sweet. But then all of a sudden that character can become something, can literally become a hero and save the day in episode. And I think our viewers will see something like that and go, I'm that. I've done that for someone. And so even being a hero, you know.
Yeah. Anyone who can consistently fill a coffee cup is my hero.
Yeah. And the show just has so many really great characters, and they're all unique. And there's something different about each one that makes them so special and lovable.
Even the villains.
Yeah.
This is true.
Yeah. Yeah. No, for sure.
And, you know,
yeah.
Without the villains, would they really be heroes?
Well, like, don't we kind of...
Yeah.
Anyway.
Oh, man. That's just asking, like, what a hero is.
Like, what being a hero is, yeah.
I did. Like, Bakugo? Is Bakugo really... Because I keep thinking he could switch over to our team very easily. And Cliff really insists that is not even possible. Well, that's like, man, but you seem pretty irritated all the time, like more than my dude does.
He's actually soft, you know, like he's like a porcupine.
Right. On the inside, right, once, like, you get to the gooey center.
He's actually like, okay, if he could reach my little ball, it'd be okay.
I think he would love this characterization of his characterization.
He's a gooey porcupine, guys. Yes. What if he said?
For sure. Yeah, even his hair is like it, so.
But something to be said about the villains, but really, like, they all have body. It's not where they're just pigeonholed as, like, you know...
They're not caricatures.
The reason that they are villains, like, they're heroes in their own mind, I think, you know? Yeah. And they also have an ensemble of friends and comrades that believe a thing.
Little more effed up, I think.
A little more. But, like, it's hard to not talk about the story because I don't know who's going to watch this. But anyway, like, with Stain and everything, like, some people are like, yes, that guy. And the people that rally behind this one character, villains and heroes alike, you're like, whoa, whoa, who's this dude who's, like, drawing this very specific group of people? And then, of course, All Might, who's like, I am here. And you're like, oh, yeah, that. I want to be like that. And, of course, that draws its own crowd.
I've never played a villain with, you know, massive facial scarring that is a bad guy that fans have reacted so positively to. It's so strange.
And, Dobby's
or even
sexy.
Think that he's, like, really sexy. And I'm like, this man has scars all over him. But
you're into it.
Yeah, okay, great. And honestly, I think I've only seen one male cosplayer of Dobby. I've seen tons of female cosplayers.
Really?
Yeah.
There's something to be...
Interesting.
Yeah.
I have seen no male Midnight cosplayers.
I have not.
That would be a brave individual.
Indeed.